Sei in compagnia di SBS Italian.
Slow Italian, fast learning.
Con il suo approccio operatico, Kate Miller-Heidke ha conquistato il cuore dell'Australia quando ha eseguito dal vivo il suo successo Zero Gravity.
Zero Gravity, Zero Gravity.
Ha così vinto la prima finale di Eurovision Australia Decides, che si è tenuta sulla Gold Coast. La sua esibizione ha vinto sia nel voto popolare sia in quello della giuria, composta da esperti del settore. Rappresenterà l'Australia allo Eurovision Song Contest di quest'anno, che si terrà a Tel Aviv. Si tratta della quinta artista a rappresentare l'Australia nella competizione.
I think I'm most looking forward to what it's like backstage, the energy backstage. I've heard that it's just, you know, everything, obviously, production, lighting, sets, it's on another level. But I mean, just the idea of there being this mini United Nations backstage and every artist is so diverse and different. I just think it's going to be incredible.
Hey you. It's me again. Hey you. Stone in my shoe. I've been aching, feeling low. You're so heavy. I have.
La canzone Zero Gravity di Miller-Heidke parla della sua esperienza con la depressione post-natale. Nella sua esibizione sulla Gold Coast, la cantante era vestita con un lungo abito e una parrucca, accompagnata da un ballerino su un palo che danzava alle sue spalle. Anche se è stata una performance coinvolgente, secondo Kate, lo scenario di Tel Aviv sarà ancora migliore.
It is an emotional song for me, and it's a personal song, and it's, you know, it feels like the song is rooted in deep emotion for me. So that's really important. In fact, I think that's the most important thing, that the staging can capture that without too many distractions visually. You know, obviously the production has to enhance and lift the roof off, but at the same time, it all comes down to the emotion of the song. Without that, you know, it's just a bunch of distractions.
Miller-Heidke sta iniziando a preparare la sua voce affrontando un'intensa attività di addestramento vocale, che comprende cantare attraverso cannucce e persino strisciare sul pavimento.
In terms of the crawling, people have been asking me about the crawling, and that's all about disengaging the critical brain, you know, the left brain. When you're singing classically, I mean, I'm doing a pop song, but the middle section is highly operatic, and opera singing is very much an athletic pursuit. It's about these tiny muscles here, and if you overthink it, you're going to screw yourself up. Especially when it gets to that crazy high note, I've just got to basically leap off the cliff and go for it. And as soon as I start to doubt myself, that's when I'm in trouble. So doing something unrelated with your body, like crawling as fast as you can, forces that analytical brain to switch off.
La lista dei partecipanti allo Eurovision Song Contest di quest'anno è completa. 41 paesi saranno in competizione. Miller-Heidke ha molti predecessori illustri con cui misurarsi, dopo le entusiasmanti esibizioni dei passati concorrenti australiani: Guy Sebastian, Dami Im, Isaiah Firebrace e Jessica Mauboy. La cantante ha detto di essersi consultata con alcuni dei concorrenti precedenti.
Speaking with Dami in a couple of days too, just sort of picking their brains about what the experience is really like. But from what I can glean so far, you know, it's very much a marathon. I mean, it's competitive music, which is like a whole new world for me. I mean, I've never done any of those sort of talent shows or anything like this before.
La prima semifinale del festival si svolgerà a Tel Aviv a metà maggio.
sbs.com.au/italian